Here we're going to continue what we were working on in a previous video, which is basically going through section 2.5. You can't see that. Is section 2.5 of the Graham Knuth and Potashnik book, Concrete Mathematics, trying to find all kinds of different ways to find this. Now, we already know the answer, but we're just practicing to show that there's like a million different processes that you can use to get to the final answer and to just kind of practice those. So in this particular one, we're going to do something called perturbing the sum. Which means that we're going to kind of add additional terms and kind of mess around with them. So if we start out with something like square sub n plus n squared or n plus 1 squared, then what that gets you is square sub n plus 1. Okay. Now, we know by definition that square sub n plus 1 would also be the same thing as k is equal to 0 to n plus 1. Of k squared. So we're just taking the same definition and applying it to the n plus 1 term. Okay? Now, we're going to play around with this. Now, we can kind of tell that this having the 0 here at the bottom isn't helping. So we can actually just go ahead and rewrite this as k going from 1 to n plus 1 of k squared, right? Because who cares if we add 0 squared because it's just 0. I can actually rewrite the whole sum without the zero, okay? But now that I've rewritten it without the zero, I actually kind of wish that the index started at zero. So if I want to take one away from here, I can take one away from the top and the bottom of k. If I want to change the index on k, whenever I take it off of the bottom, that means I need to add it into the top, okay? Not the bottom, the top, I should say. If I'm going to reduce the index, let me try to sound this like an adult. If I'm going to reduce the index of k on the limits of the summation, I need to increase every reference to k in the summand by the same value, which would be 1. Does that sound grown up? It does. Okay. So that means that now, again, the k is going to go from 0 to n, but now on the inside of there, I have k plus 1 squared. Okay. And honestly, all of these methods come, I think, can be summarized as flash of inspiration, but in a slightly different way, okay? So what we can see here, maybe, because I can write these summations out separately, so k equals 0 to n, k squared, k equals 0 to n, 2k, and k equals 0 to n of 1. All right, now, this one here, I already actually know because it's this one, all right? So it's that one there. So I'm going to go ahead and plug that in as box sub n. Now this one here, I should already know, but yeah. For the moment, let's pretend that we don't, just for funsies. So I'm going to pull the k out, or the 2 out. 0 to n of k. And now just to make sure you understand what this is, we're adding 1. So it's 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. So how many times are we adding the 1 together? You might be tempted to say n, but we're actually adding the n plus 1 terms of those. So 1 times, well, n plus 1 is just going to be n plus 1. So what I want you to do now is realize we have this over here and we have this over here. So we're going to combine them. So I've got square n plus n squared plus 1 is equal to square n plus 2 times this summation plus n plus 1. Not k squared, just regular k. Okay, just regular k. Okay, so now I can go ahead and cross those both off, they cancel out, and I'm just going to rearrange some terms. So I have that k going from 0 to n of k, the summation of k, is equal to 1 half of, and that's going to be n squared plus 2n plus 1 minus n minus 1. So I'll just keep writing this over here. So it's n squared plus n. So basically what I've determined is k going from 0 to n of k is equal to n times n plus 1 over 2. And that's not what we were looking for, but actually we just accidentally prove something we already knew, and you're like, but I didn't know that. Remember, it's the whole thing where if you're adding 1 to 100, you could also come over here and add 99 down to 1, and that gives you 101 and 101 and 101, 101, but there's 100 of these terms. So basically, twice the sum is equal to, so twice the sum is equal to 100 times 101. So the sum would be equal to 100 times 101 over 2, which is, again, if you're going from 1 to n, instead of doing 100 and 101, it'd be n times n plus 1 over 2. So we've had this in other videos elsewhere, but we basically proved something we already knew, which wasn't actually what we were trying to do, but that was kind of neat. Yay. So actually, if nothing else, you know, we can be, I guess, irritated at the fact that we spent time proving something that we didn't actually need to prove, or we can realize that this might actually lead us to a good way to get what we are looking for. So the idea was, before, when we were looking to sum, we actually ended up finding sum. So when we're looking for sum squared, we got sum. So basically what we're going to do is, let's try looking for sum cubed and hope that we actually get sum squared. So it's like, oh, we failed, but in failure, maybe we'll come up with something clever. All right, so let's try that. And there we go. Okay, so let's define a new thing. So we're going to call this cube sub n. All right, oops, cube sub n. So for cube sub n, going from k equals 0 to n of k cubed. All right, so basically the same thing. Now let's do this thing where we perturb the sum again, and maybe we'll get lucky. So we've got cube sub n plus n plus 1 cubed. That's going to be cube sub n plus 1. All right, now again, applying that same definition, that's going to be k going from 0 to n plus 1 of k cubed. Okay. So just like we did last time, we realized that the k sub 0 doesn't actually get us anywhere. So we're just going to drop that term. And then we've got k cubed. Now we're going to adjust the limits on the summation by reducing them by 1. And in return, we're going to increase that same limit, or that same variable in the summand, by 1. And it just sounds so fancy when we use words like summand. All right, so now we're going from k equals 0 to n again. And k plus 1 now cubed. All right. So hopefully you remember your Pascal's triangle and 1, 3, 3, 1. So those are going to be our coefficients for the cube term. So we've got k going from 0 to n of k cubed plus 3k squared plus 3k plus 1. And now we're going to apply the sum to each one of those terms separately. And I'm also going to pull this back down. So we had sub n plus 1 cubed is equal to, if I kind of apply all the summation separately, that's just going to be that same cube term, right? Because that's the original definition. And then the summation I'm going to apply to each one of those separately, 3k squared and k equals 0 to n, 3k and k equals 0. To n times 1. All right, so again, these terms are going to cancel out and you should get kind of excited. So n plus 1 cubed, again, n cubed plus 3n squared plus 3n plus 1. On the right, this is the thing that we're actually trying to look for. Oops, if I took the 3 out, I don't need it there. K squared. And I can pull this out. From 0 to n of k. And again, like just like last time, there are n plus 1 of these ones. Okay, so I've got this over here, n cubed plus 3n squared plus 2n is 3, junky junk junk junk. And in fact, if you want, we can go ahead and replace this with square sub n, right? And then this 3, we've already determined multiple times that this is going to be equal to n times n plus 1 over 2. And we've already moved the n plus 1 over. All right, so if we're trying to find square sub n, we're going to have 3n squared plus 3 over 2, right? Yes. You know what? I'm feeling lazy, so I'm just going to actually multiply this whole thing by 2 because I just want to. So I'm going to multiply the whole thing by 2 just to get rid of those, get rid of that little fraction-y thing. I don't feel like dealing with that right now. I'm not emotionally ready to deal with fractions. 6n and then 2n cubed, 6n squared. I'm finding this very difficult for some reason. Minus 3n squared minus 3, I believe. Minus 3n. Oof. Holy mackerel. All right. So 6 square n, 2n cubed, 3n squared plus n. All right. This is looking promising. I'm kind of excited. Because look what's going to happen. Okay. So I can pull an n out, and I've got 2n squared plus 3n plus 1, which means I can do this. 2n, I've already established it apparently. Factoring out polynomials is not something I can do at 11:30 at night on a Saturday. This should be a 1. Yes, inner, outer, last. Okay, good, woohoo! So that means that, in fact, square sub n is equal to n, 2n plus 1, n plus 1, over 6. So I was able to find a closed form, again, by perturbing the sum. And even though, so it's kind of funny though, right? Because originally I thought I was doing it right and I got an answer for a problem I wasn't even looking for. So then I had to go and be like, oh, okay, well, if that didn't work, let me try doing it for one kind of level above it. And then I was able to actually go get this figured out. So I don't even need to prove this because the derivation itself is the proof. So I don't need to go ahead and prove this by induction because I didn't guess. I actually demonstrated this. So yay, that's another way, another method that you can use to solve this exact same problem and get the exact same answer. Woohoo!